cute little girls, you know. When she shows up, it just cracks me up to watch them try to figure out. Now, this woman's scary. If she said pick something up, you pick it up. If she say move it, you move it, and move it when she say move it. Amen. So I appreciate her. Give Pastor Kenneth Smith from Living Faith Church, Singer, Louisiana. Come on. Y'all don't need me to tell any stories about Pastor Kenneth, do you? You know, about him giving me drugs right before I preached one time. You remember that? You remember that? All the stuff we done, bike rides, crazy stuff. Proud of this man. So excited about him being here and proud of him being senior pastor again. All right, that's enough, fellows.
tonight.
That changed me right there. Amen. Get ready for the pool.
Hey.
That's all. Sit down just for a brief minute. I'll let you get out of here in time to go eat, whatever you do. For those who came over from New Caney area, thanks for coming over tonight. Let me encourage you to make that drive over to New Caney tomorrow night. Pastor Kenneth's going to preach a different sermon tomorrow night. And after hearing this tonight, I can't wait. Bro, I get so many notes when I listen to you. I mean, my iPad's full of notes tonight. I wrote them down. I'm going to put some meat on it and really preach it. That's what he do to me all the time. He said, you give me a sermon, I'll put some meat on and preach it. I tell you something else you used to do to me, Pastor Kenneth. I need you and Sandy to go stand in the back of the church. First time I preached for you, this how you did this to me. And it reminded me, he says, we're gonna give his pastor an offering tonight. And I want y'all to go back there and stick it in his jacket. Embarrass the fire out of me. Cause we had a good church, and I loved it. But one thing that always bothered me was that come back and they put that money, and they look you right in the eye, and then you, Richard, you have to look at them and go, it's like you have that little guilt feeling if you don't put something in their pocket. Someone just stuck a hand in their pocket, grabbed something, pulled it out, and walked away. So I need you to go to the back. Stay obedient. If you get a bucket, H., stand back there. I don't put it in his pocket. Just put it in the bucket. How about that? Travis, you got somebody. Somebody help me out here. Amen. If you need a tithe or offering envelope, it's in front of you. We want to give a good offering tonight to Pastor Kenneth. And let me just say this to you. You're not giving because he needs it. You're not giving him an offering tonight because he needs it. He has a job. Amen. He pastors a church. He does well. I need it. I need to honor him. I need to sow into his life. I need to say, listen, guys, I went to the hospitals and saw him in Louisiana when I thought he wasn't going to make it. I rode over there to Sandy on my bike, me and Richard, when he was so depressed, we didn't know if he'd pull out of it. And to watch you now, sir, you in the deep end of the pool. One of the things, Tommy Balk, it bothers me a whole lot is when I ask somebody a question and they give me a whole dialogue. Jesus asked a man, do you want to be well? What's the answer? Yes or no? Answer the question. Don't make me stand here when I got to go deal with a whole bunch of other people. Yes or no? And he goes through a dialogue. Well, I ain't got nobody to put me in the pool. I've been here 38 years. And he just goes on and on and on. And you know what Jesus said to him right after that? It's the only time that I know in the Word of God he says it. Watch. Take up your bed and walk. You see, now, Pastor, he said that before. Yeah, but he didn't say it like this. He didn't say your faith made you whole. Everywhere else he said your faith. There are people sitting here right now. You got faith to be healed. But you'd rather lean on your excuses. You got to say, you know what? He said to me, he told me to be well, I'm going to be well. Amen. I'm going to keep on pressing. No more excuses. So he never said to the man, you faith. Why? Because he knew the man had faith. Some folk would rather let folk help them for 38 years than to get well. I'd rather be on disability. But don't touch me, Jesus. I'm on disability. Don't want to lose my check. That's a little mean, I know. That's a Boudreaux joke. That's old. Everybody got your offering? I want you to give something tonight. Again, Frank, I want to say again to you guys, thank you for getting the parking lot striped. Amen. Appreciate that. Tomorrow morning, 8:45, out at the ranch. I'm saying this for Keith. Amen. And Keith, we got 8:45. We're going to do ropes course. We got 90 kids in one day. And then it's pretty much over for the summer. I know you never complain, sir, but you know what? You've been there all summer, and you still ain't got a tan, so I don't know what's up. Man, the man has helped us out. He's been a friend. You know, we've had several. The Lord, when he made you, he said, we need just one more redhead. And that's it. Appreciate you, sir. Amen. So come out in the morning if you can. Hang out with us. Pastor Kenneth will be with me out on the tower. And we'll be discussing tomorrow night's message and what went wrong tonight. Clothing ministry will be open on Sunday out in the North Campus, of course. If you need. Listen, guys, we have great clothes out there, too. I mean, I got a friend that told me, he said, I was waiting on you to put your Harley shirts out there, Pastor. I went in and got every one of them. And I said, well, don't forget them britches I dropped off in there, too. You know, it's just good clothes. I get clothes from there, and it's not a problem. Ladies are going to get together on August the 13th. Amen. Again, it's a Saturday. Is that right? Amen. And the sign-up sheet back in the back, ladies. You got a conference coming up in September. We want our ladies strong in this church. So gather. Pastor Joseph going to be kicking off the youth here with Forge. What day is that, Joseph? You're going to do it on Wednesday night. That's right, on the 17th. Going to be coming over here on the 17th. So we're excited about that. And also, man, as soon as the end of August gets here, it's Friday Night Lights. Amen. Gathering with the kids on Friday night and the ball and all of that. So you see the rest of the announcements. Seniors for the Purpose will be gathering August the 14th. A lot of good things. Stand with me. Father, we thank you for the gift and the giver tonight. We understand there's a difference in our tithe and our offering. Tonight we want to give an offering to a man of God that came, that has survived, that has overcome. Lord, we want to thank you also for Charlie's testimony. Lord, our hearts have been touched. We've grown fonder, more excited about what you can do in the life of someone whose life looked shattered and the devil looked like they had them. I thank you for the grace of God. In Jesus' name, amen. God bless you guys. Good to have y'all here. Come out tomorrow night, 7 o'clock.